Just give them all to me so you can pass them all out to everyone. Yeah, give me one.
Thank you. What'd you say, Diane? Diane. Did you? Do you have to share it with me?
Thank you. the seat of this.
Welcome to Sacred Heart Church, to the Mass of the Resurrection for Mark Garcia. Our celebrant for the Mass is Father Luis Gonzalez, Associated Pastor for Sacred Heart Church. We ask that you please turn off or silence all cell phones at this time. Thank you.
Entre tus manos.
Espírito Santo. In the waters of baptism, Christ died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. Please stand. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is a certain hope and faith that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant, Mark Garcia, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share in the joy of resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
Reading from the Book of Wisdom. The just man, though he die early, shall be at rest. For the age that is honorable comes not with the passing of time, nor can it be measured in terms of years. Rather, understanding is a horary crown for men, and the unsullied life the attainment of old age. He who pleased God was loved. He who lived among sinners was transformed. Snatched away, lest wickedness pervert his mind and decide beguile his soul. For the witchery of paltry things obscures what is right, and the world's desire transforms the innocent mind. Having become perfect in a short while, he reached the fulfillment of a long career. For his soul was pleasing to the Lord, therefore he sped him out to the midst of the wickedness. But the people saw and did not understand, nor did they take this into account. The word of the Lord.
The responsorial is, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Besides restful waters he leads me, he restores my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. There is nothing I shall want. He guides me in the right path for my name's sake. Even though I walk in the valley of the shadow of fear, for you are at my side, with your rod and your staff, that you give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anointed my head with oil, my cup overflows. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Only goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want."
Alleluia, alleluia. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who could be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Jesus Christ who died, rather, was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or the sword? No, in all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life nor angels nor principalities nor present things nor future things nor powers nor height nor depth nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Jesus Christ our Lord. The word is the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus journeyed to a city called Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd accompanied him. As he drew near to the gate of the city, a man had died, was young, was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. A large crowd from the city was with her. When the Lord saw her, he was moved with pity for her and said to her, "Do not weep." He stepped forward and touched the coffin. At this, the bearers halted, and he said, "Young man, I tell you, arise." The dead man sat up and began to speak. And Jesus gave him to his mother. Fear seized them all, and the glorified God exclaiming, "A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people." This report about him spread through the whole of Judea and all the surroundings. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please say, "Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ." Please be seated. Dear brothers and sisters, we are here to celebrate and ask God to give eternal life to Mark Garcia. We are here, brothers and sisters, to show our unity, our solidarity, our oneness, our great reverence to the life of our brother. Let me tell you, brothers and sisters, for the Catholic Church, when a member of a community suffers, the entire community suffers. For the Catholic Church, when a member of the community dies, the entire community dies a little in the heart. Let me tell you, it is because in the Catholic Church, each member counts. Each member is most valuable. Each member is indispensable. And today, Mark is a member. He's a member of the church. He is an inseparable part of the Catholic Church. And therefore, together with the family, together with all of you, dear friends, the Catholic Church of the Sacred Heart, the members of the Sacred Heart, we grieve and we are with you to show our sorrow, our pain, and also to show our faith and our hope, hope in the resurrection. The death of a brother, brothers and sisters, even though the situation is difficult, it is a cross the entire Catholic community carries. The Lord says, take up your cross and come after me. You will not be worthy of me if you do not take up your cross. And therefore, this is a heavy cross through the death of a brother that all of us, and especially the entire Catholic community, carries today with a heavy heart, heart full of pain and sorrow. Although, brothers and sisters, the cause of the death does not matter. The death itself is a moment for us to ask, question life, question what is death, what is death for? And so important that every occasion like this, we begin to question life and ask, what is the meaning of life? And today is a very good opportunity to think about life and the direction that it should take for each one of us. Brothers and sisters, as we offer this Mass for our brother, sad as we are, sorrowful as we all are, painful as this moment is, let this death not go in vain. Let this death of a brother, let this separation of a brother not go in vain, because it has eternal value. It has eternal meaning. And therefore, let us see what it is, what opportunity this moment like this, when we grieve, offers to each one of us. I'm sure our brother, now he cannot pray for himself, and we all need to pray for him. But he will surely wish the best for each one of us who are still here on this earth. He will wish the best for you and for me. And therefore, brothers and sisters, let us dwell deeply into the readings from the Holy Bible that the family has chosen. The first reading is taken from the Book of Wisdom. It was written way before Jesus Christ our Lord. And it is called the Book of Wisdom. And in that book, in that part of the scripture, wisdom is there, wisdom. And according to the first reading, which our sisters read today, we are told, long life is not the measure of life. Long life is not the sign of wisdom, not necessarily. And short life does not mean waste or wasteness of life. So long life does not mean someone died with wisdom. And short life does not mean somebody died useless. What this reading tells us is, the wisdom of life consists in pleasing God. The wisdom of life consists in doing God's will. The wisdom of life consists in being perfect in front of God. Being perfect, brothers and sisters. Take note of this first reading. What matters is not short life like a brother or long life like someone else. What matters is the perfection in life. The closeness to God. Closeness to God's will in our life. And therefore the first reading says that a life that is perfect is pleasing to God. I was told that he lived life to the full. He was so family person. He was so full of goodness in heart, mind, and body. He was so full of life. Let us pray that whatever good he has done may benefit him for eternal life. Because the measure of life is not the length of life, the measure of life is the quality of life. How you and me will live. What a beautiful reading, brothers and sisters, that we ask this perfection, this fullness be our brother here as he passes from this world to the next world. The second reading, brothers and sisters, taken from St. Paul, says us this. It immediately compares the death of this young person, Mark, to the death of Christ. Jesus Christ was only 33 years younger than Mark. So the death of Christ and death of our brother is directly connected. Young they died, young they left us, sad and dejected to the family, but they have a reason to live. We are told, brothers and sisters, the second reading says, even though we are sad because our brother has left us, neither death, nor anguish, nor sadness, nor misery, nor unfortunate circumstances, nothing, no principalities, no power, no evil, no money, no pleasure, no prestige, nothing will separate us from the love of God. How wonderful, brothers and sisters, this reading from second reading, taken from Romans chapter 8, nothing will separate us from the love of God. And Romans 8:31 says, if God be for us, who can be against us? If God is with us, no one can be against us. No one can possibly be against us. And let us take the strength from this. And it says, nothing will separate us from the love of God, and the creature will always dwell in the love of God. We need, brothers and sisters, to draw wisdom from this reading. And therefore, the gospel today says, young man, come out. And the young man who died in the gospel today, the son of a only widow, rose again and lived. Jesus performed miracle. He brought back to life the young man. Jesus performed this miracle. Today he will perform this miracle. He will bring back our brother to life eternal, to the resurrection. And therefore, let us be full of faith, full of hope, full of challenges, to live this life for God, to live this life with meaning, to live this life with conviction and values. Let the death of our brother, nothing may go in vain. Let it spur us on. Let it inspire us, challenge us to live a life for God, to live a life for meaning, to live a life for values of life. If God is for us, who can be against us? If God is for our brother today, nothing can separate us from love of God. So all of us who are gathered here, large number, you all loved him, you all loved the family, and your gratitude and gratefulness, brothers and sisters, should express in the change of direction life should take. It is useless many times just to be sentimental, just to be full of feelings, just to be feelings. Every one of us can be sentimental. Every one of us can be just feeling. Today we are sad, tomorrow we are normal. No. The feeling should lead us to question our own life, take a new direction. If the direction that we are into is not so good, let us take a direction towards God, towards human beings, towards truth, sincerity, conviction of life, towards goodness. May all of you brothers who have come here, brothers and sisters, who have come here to pay rich tribute to Mark Garcia and his family, may decide today to follow the example of eternal life, to follow the path of life eternal, to be full of convictions. Therefore, I offer my condolences to the family, to the dearest and near ones, to the entire family who are grieving today. I offer my condolences to all the friends who will miss him today, all the dear and near ones who were associated with him. I offer my sincere condolences. Let us hope, brothers and sisters, in the life eternal that our Lord Jesus teaches us. Let us hope, brothers and sisters, so that our soul will be full of peace. In this world, peace is not there. If the peace is there, peace is not in my heart. My heart is grieving. My heart is so full, busy doing things, not trying to be peaceful, trying to be tranquil. Brothers and sisters, let us ask God that our brother will enjoy eternal life, eternal rest. And with him, brothers and sisters, let us aim for a life that is without tears, without pain, without yen. Let us aim for a life that is without pain, without tears, and without end. Eternal life. Amen. Please stand. Let us put before God our prayers and petitions.
Baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Let us pray to the Lord. For my dad, who is nourished at the table of the Savior, that he may be welcomed into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord.
For all people that may come more and more to believe, to trust, and to love God, and so enter into eternal life, let us pray to the Lord. For my dad, that God may accept the goodness to which he led him in this life and give him the reward he has generously promised, let us pray to the Lord.
For all who have gathered here to worship in faith, that we may be one in the kingdom of God, let us pray to the Lord. For all the faithful departed, particularly for Lila Molina, Victor Flores, Anthony, and Marianne Ortega, that we may enjoy the blessedness of eternal life, let us pray to the Lord.
God our Father, give eternal life to our brother here. and let the family receive strength and courage today. Very especially, let those who are near to him receive new direction in life. Amen. Please be seated. Offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your brother, of your servant, Mar Garcia. We beseech your mercy that he who died did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those who sadden by the certainty of dying may be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ending. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Dios del universo, Upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples saying, take this all of you and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring us to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Jose Gomez, our Bishop, all the clergy, remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in hope of the resurrection. Remember your servant Mark Garcia, whom you called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
In the Catholic Church, brothers and sisters, we have one of the most beautiful prayers that Jesus himself taught us. Jesus himself taught his disciples to pray. Let us be full of faith, praying for our brother and praying for each other, united as we are brothers and sisters of one God's family, let us pray this prayer of our Father in a most solemn way, in a very spirited way, and say to God the Father that you are our Father. Our Father, what in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace and amaze, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
Ven y quien hable de ti, tu fe. envíame, Señor, mi Dios. Señor, quiero servirte. Señor, aquí estoy. Mi vida hoy te entrego. Mi corazón te doy.
Brothers and sisters, we are so happy that you all are here. And we pray for you during this Mass, for each and every one of you. Please remember this, the body of Christ. We believe it is the very body of Christ is only for those Catholics, practicing Catholics, who have received sacraments. Others may come forward if they wish with a folded hand to receive a blessing. Thank you very much for your kindness. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey. Mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Mark Garcia may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Brothers and sisters, on behalf of the family, on behalf of the Sacred Heart Church, I thank each and every one of you for being here. Let us listen to God. Let us listen to God's ways and give rich tribute to our brother Mark. On behalf of Sacred Heart Church, I express my sincere condolences to the family, to the dear and dear ones, and we share your sorrow, your pain in this time, and we are with you. God bless each and every one of you. May all of us together do God's will in our life. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, may he rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessing which you have bestowed upon his life. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayer. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurance of faith until we all meet and we are with you, with our brothers and sisters. Amen. Let us pray silently for our brother. As we pray silently for Mark Garcia, let us listen to you, Lord.
Hello. My husband, he had stage 4 lymphoma cancer. We've been married 24 years. I have to write it down because I'm a mess. We've been married 24 years and 27 years together. We have 4 kids, 5 grandkids. It's been a long ride with him. We had many obstacles thrown our way, but our love kept us together. We had a love like no other. He was a strength to our family. He always made sure everyone was okay. When I was down, he lifted me up. He taught me to always keep pushing forward. He told me that he's not gonna be around too long, that I had to learn to get by without him. He wanted me to be strong and know how to defend myself. He had such a big heart. If you got to meet him, you just knew he was gonna protect you and make you laugh and make sure you were financially okay, even if it was his last dollar. He made sure nobody went without eating. He would sometimes He would bring bones home to feed them and make sure they showered. Our house was always open for anyone who needed a place to stay. He left a special bond with so many of you guys. He was a fighter. He fought his whole life, but this last year was a different kind of fight for him. He put up a good fight, and I'm so proud of him. I watched him fight till he took his last breath. And he's gonna be missed. Thank you, everyone, for all the support you have helped us and showed to us and to my family. My husband would be grateful.
Let us pray. Merciful God, turn towards us and listen to our prayer. Open the gates of paradise to your servant. Help his family to remain firm. Follow the steps of God that he has taught us. And until we all meet again in Christ and are with you, with our brother, we ask this to Christ our Lord. Pray for God's blessing. May God bless all of you, very especially to follow the path of God, to follow the path of goodness, to lead life meaningfully and for a greater cause than ourselves. And may angels guide you. May God be with you and protect you all, especially from this pandemic. May God bless you in the Father, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In silence, we take leave of our brother.
Para
corazón, Dios mío, mañana quizás no vendrá. Ayúdame hoy, yo quiero vivir un día a la vez. Tú ya viviste entre los hombres. Tú sabes, Señor, que hoy está peor, es mucho el dolor.